You can see right here that I'm using a script to make a screencast of my screen and record my voice. Now, how do I do this? It's very simple. I used to use OBS, but ever since I switched to OpenBSD, well, I've gotten a lot more minimalist, and I don't want to install a billion unnecessary dependencies I'm only using for one program. So what did I decide to do instead? Figure out how to record my screen using an FFmpeg, figure out how to record my voice using Aucat or Aucat, whatever it's called. I think it's Aucat because it's supposed to be cat, like the program concatenate and aw as in audio. So let's just go and get into how to do this. So I'm going to move this to the 9th tag, but you can still see that we are recording. So let's run edsc, which is edit script, and not on swallow because that is the last video I've recorded. I'm recording a lot of videos in a row right now because I have a sudden spark of inspiration, but they'll probably be released incrementally anyways. And we're going to do screencast. Now this script is very simple. You can see it's only 17 lines and there's line breaks and stuff, and some of them are unnecessary. It's not super optimized, but you get the point. So the first thing that it does, the technical first thing it does is it's written in POSIX SH. Okay, now the first real thing it does is it asks for the title, and it prints out like what do you want the title to be, and it reads the title. And then it uses that title and places any spaces in the title with underscores. It just makes it easier to do like folder names and stuff. And then the second thing is it creates that folder name, the directory name, using the title dash the Unix time, basically the Unix timestamp. So if we do the command date plus %s, it'll print out the Unix time. And you can see that it increments slowly. Obviously, it increments by 1 every second. If you're not familiar with Unix time, they use it on 4chan for image upload, so there you go. Anyways, and it makes that directory based off of this final dir name variable. Then we have a gap to signify that we're going to a new part of the script. So here we go. Here's the video part. So FFmpeg, we change the log level to only display logs if there's a fatal error that causes it to exit. That way you can debug, but otherwise you don't need all that unnecessary information on the screen. Video size 1600 by 900. I might automate doing this by like some maybe XRander printing out the screen resolution or something, but my ThinkPad is 1600 by 900, so it doesn't really make sense to set it as anything else for right now. Frame rate 30 because I don't need a re-recording, and 60 for generic screencasts. If I was gaming or something, which I'm not on my ThinkPad, then maybe I wouldn't. Maybe I'd record in 60, but 30 is good. So dash F is basically how it's going to be grabbing my screen through X11 grab. Not really important. The rest of this is really just like encoding stuff, and then it outputs it to that specific thing, that specific directory. video.mkv sends anything to devnull, which I could literally just get rid of that because I have the log level set to fatal. And then printf video recording started, and then we're actually running in the background with this and because we also want to run Aucat and record all of the audio. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to run it in the background, say audio recording was started, and then we have it say press enter to stop recording, and what it does is it just reads a variable which will make the shell hang until you hit, well, you can type in anything and hit enter, but you can hit enter to make it basically read the variable, finish reading, and then whatever you input becomes the variable. Now we don't use this variable anywhere, we're just using it for this press enter to stop recording function, which I don't know if there's any other kind of shell function to do, but this seems to be the most simple. And then what we do is we get rid of the FFmpeg process, we get rid of the Aucat process, and because of the way that these are both stored, it doesn't matter if they're ended prematurely because it'll still have the entire file. So we can still, like MKV, if you kill it, well, you're still going to have the MKV file, but with MP4, if you kill it, you can't use that file anymore. You have to create like a footer and complete it and stuff. Much of unnecessary nonsense. And this is the same thing with WAV versus, I think, like MP3 or something. And then we go into that directory, and we basically combine both the video and audio files, because they're recorded separate, into final.mkv, and final.mkv is basically what I'm going to upload onto YouTube, because I don't really edit my videos. I make my thumbnails and I just shove them onto YouTube, and that is about it. So that was just a quick tour of my script for screencasting, and just like the last video I did, I'm actually going to add it to the Git repository. Screencast, add screencast script, git push, and that should do it after, oops, I actually screwed up my username. There we go. And so now it is uploaded to the Git repository. You can use this. The only thing it relies on are obviously FFmpeg and Aucat, as we could see before. And it's very simple, very easy to use. You need pgrep, but that's a standard core utility on literally any Unix system. And yeah, you just need core utilities, FFmpeg, Aucat, and I don't even know where Aucat came from. I don't think it's its own package. It might have come with the operating system itself or something, but I don't remember installing Aucat. Maybe it just came along with FFmpeg or something. I'm not sure, but chances are you probably have it. As you can see, it's not even a package in the repository. So chances are you have Aucat somewhere, and you can just use it for the screencasting and change the resolution if you don't want it to be 1600 by 900. That's all I have to say. Very minimalist recording, and yeah. Go have fun.